a long time ago. And Santa's forgotten his line.
Ho, 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 Merry Christmas!
That's not your cue, huh?
Oh, isn't it? I thought I was supposed to come on early.
You always come on early. Geez, when it's Christmas, I'll tell you.
Well, Christmas does come much once a year, so steady on.
Well, I would if you could, if you learnt a few new tricks.
Once upon a time.
So when do we come?
Not yet. I'll let you know.
Okay.
Alright, Mrs. Sennett, can you just control him, sit him down, and let's get on with the show.
I'm so sorry. Come on, Mum, just stay here, and I'll call it when you're ready.
Once upon a time, there were three Christmas bears who lived in the Australian outback. There was a Papa Bear. A Mama Bear. And a Baby Bear. One particular Christmas, because she was a terribly good cook, Mama Bear decided to make a figgy pudding. It was Baby Bear's favourite. She served it up into three bowls, but alas, it was far too hot.
Shall we leave the house whilst the figgy pudding cools?
Yes, that's a great idea. Let's go for a walk.
Let's go by the light, Eva Scrum.
All righty then. Put on your shoes.
So Mama Bear grabbed her shawl and they wrestled Baby Bear into his shoes and off they went. Meanwhile, there was a young lass named Goldilocks who was wandering through the bush. Pretty soon she came upon the house in the scrub that belonged to the three Christmas bears. She knocked, and when no one answered, she went in. At the table in the kitchen, there were three bowls of
figgy pudding, my favourite.
Yes, as I was saying, there were bowls of figgy pudding and Goldilocks was hungry. So she tasted the pudding from the first bowl.
Oh, this figgy pudding's too hot.
So she tasted the figgy pudding from the second bowl.
This figgy pudding is too cold.
So she tasted the last bowl of figgy pudding.
This figgy pudding is just right.
So Goldilocks ate all up. After she'd eaten the three bears' bowls of pudding, she decided she was feeling a little tired. So she walked into the living room where she saw three chairs. Goldilocks sat in the first chair to rest her feet.
Oh, this chair is much too big.
So she sat in the second chair.
This chair is much too small.
So she tried the last chair.
This chair is just right.
But as she settled down into the chair to rest, she saw a strange clock.
The hungry bears will soon be back. Get out of here, alas, alas. For if you don't make it out in time, will be Christmas dinner, you will be home.
Goldilocks was very scared. Her eyes were white, her teeth were bare. She made her way back outside, but as she walked, something sparkling caught her eye. It was the bear's Christmas tree, all lit up with presents beneath. Oh, what luck.
Give hope and strength.
steps, please, little elves. Couldn't believe it. She picked up the first present. This present was
far too heavy.
So she picked up the second present and she shook it.
This present was far too empty.
So she picked up the third present and smelled it.
This present smells so sweet.
So Goldilocks put the present in her bag and went out the back door into the forest.
Sometimes I use the back door too.
As I was saying, she left, but as she left, the three bears got home, excited to eat their figgy pudding.
Someone's been eating my figgy pudding!
Someone's been eating my figgy pudding!
Someone's been eating your figgy pudding too?
Well, no, but yes.
Someone's been eating my figgy pudding and then eating it all up!
The bears were very distressed to learn that they had been burgled, and Papa Bear knew that it wasn't the same burglar who had been burgling Mama Bear every night for the past 3 months whilst he was out hunting. Oh dear.
Someone has been sitting in my seat.
Someone's been sitting in my chair.
Someone's been sitting in my chair too.
They decided to look around some more and realised that their presents had been tampered with.
Someone has tried to pick up my present.
Someone's been shaking my present.
Pretty sure that's not the only thing that's been shaking around here.
Someone's taken my present. It's not here anymore.
Oh no!
But just as Papa Bear picked up the phone to dial the insurance company, the clock spoke.
I saw a girl with fiery hair. She went out through the back door, out through the scrub, over there.
So, off they went in search of the golden-haired child who stole Baby Bear's present. And boy, were they wild. Through the scrub, they raged and crashed. They yelled and howled. They came upon a little clearing filled with elves all busy making toys to put in Santa's sack for Christmas.
Have you seen a girl with fiery gold hair?
Yes.
Check it in twice, gonna find out.
Which way did she go?
That way. That way. That way. Follow me, I'll show you the way.
So, off they went to find Goldilocks and the missing present. Through bush
and walk through briar to find the girl with hair like fire.
But first they passed a field filled with deer. Reindeer, in fact.
Have you seen a girl with golden hair?
Yes!
Where?
Yeah.
While still the merriment of the summer turning into winter was exciting for Mama and Papa Bear, who were born in the north, Baby Bear snuck away. He was sad about the loss of his present.
I'm never gonna get my present back, am I?
Suddenly, a flock of angels flew in.
Well, we will make sure Santa has something in his sack for all
nothing a good repent won't be. No, I'm sure there'll be something in my sack for everyone, and I'll leave a wonderful gift.
Oh, right, well, I've made one last little adjustment to the roof. Now be sure you don't run into any gum trees. Remember, Christmas in Australia is hot.
What do you call a cat on the beach at Christmas time? Oh, everyone knows my jokes. You're Sandy Paws. I'll go another one then. What do you give your deep fry Santa Claus? Crisp Kringle. Thanks, Will.
She came to my house unannounced.
who? Black girls with red hair?
Oh, yes, red girls. I also like girls with hair like fire. I like to eat them because I'm a cannibal.
I'll second that. Oh, that was okay. It was way before I even met you. It's okay.
The time has come. It's almost here. The very best part of the year. So raise your voices, sing and have some fun. Merry Christmas to all of you, each and every one.
We